to the Bill Clinton campaign. Gentlemen, thanks to both of you for joining us. David, I can't help noticing number one on that list was the economy. And the thing that's going to make a difference in the economy is tax reform. I mean, they must really feel the pressure today. What do you think?
Any Republican who sits in a district with more than two traffic lights has to figure out how they get to yes on tax cuts, because in 3 months, 95% of voters aren't going to remember who the governors of New Jersey and Virginia are, but they are going to know where their member of Congress was on whether taxes got cut or not.
So, Simon, I'm imagining that Democrats smell blood in the water. This tax deal is right there on the table. What is one thing that you think you could change about this bill that would make it more palatable to Democrats?
I don't think that's the issue, Melissa.
What's one thing?
It's not talking points. I actually understand what they're proposing, and I don't think the Democrats are going to support a bill that dramatically cuts taxes for very wealthy people,
so
drives
is that
up the deficit.
The estate tax?
I'm going to finish. May I finish?
Well, you're doing talking points.
No, I'm not doing. It's insulting that you say that to me as if I don't actually understand what I'm saying and can do my own analysis about the economy.
But you're not answering the question.
No, I am answering the question, which is Democrats are not going to support tax reform that dramatically cuts taxes on people that don't need tax cuts and prevents middle-class people from sharing in the benefits of these tax cuts while driving up the deficit. We're never going to support that framework. So if they want to move, as Senator Wyden said, to a bipartisan approach, right, we are very open to staying focused on the middle class and not driving up the deficit.
Okay.
That's what the Democrats want to do.
Melissa,
so David,
here's how you get...
Hang on. Okay, so after that speech, if we want to drill down on the actual details and try and make some progress, the nut of what he just said is the overall argument. So if you're trying to actually get something done, the first thing you might strip away, maybe it's that death tax, saying, taking that off the table, putting it back, saying we're going to leave the death tax alone. Maybe that would get more Democrats, not Simon, who's not willing to come to the table at all, but real Democrats to the table.
Here's what gets Democrats to the table. Republicans getting to 51 votes. And then all of a sudden, six or seven Democrats are all of a sudden going to be for tax reform. Democrats are not going to help pass tax cuts unless Republicans get it across the line, and it's already going to vote for it. Democrats think that if they stop tax cuts, they can put Republicans in a bad spot going into the elections. Democrats aren't going to do one thing to pass tax cuts. If we're going to get tax cuts for the American people, it's going to be because the Republican majorities deliver it.
Simon, do you want to prove him right? Are you guys not going to do one thing to pass tax cuts? I mean, I asked you for one thing. Do you want to give me one thing?
No, I think Melissa, you know, I've come on this show with you many times. You do the same thing over and over again.
No, I don't. I just want you to answer the question I asked.
No, I'm not answering the question. I'm answering the question.
I know you're not answering the question. That's the problem.
So the point is that Democrats are not going to agree to a tax cut plan that overwhelmingly benefits wealthy
people.
You
already said that.
Drives up the deficit.
You already said that.
But that's what's being proposed. So we're not going to support it.
Repeating yourself isn't helping the argument. I'm asking you, like we're asking everyone, to come to the table and try and offer something productive.
Right.
Give me three things you want to strip away.
The productive answer.
Maybe it's the estate tax. Maybe it's SALT. I mean, tell me what you don't like about this. Can you be specific?
No, we reject the entire. Melissa, I just told you, right, that we reject the frame that is being proposed here. We do not agree
so
that this is going to be good
for
growth.
There's literally nothing in there that's decent.
We don't agree with the frame of the deal. What Senator Wyden said is what is the Democratic position, is that if the Republicans want to come to the table and work with us on tax cuts that actually really benefit middle-class people and don't drive up the deficit, we're game to do it, right? We've done it before. Our party's done it before.
So the tax cuts that are in there for the middle class, doubling the standard deduction, all the things that are in there, you don't like any of that would help working people, Simon?
You understand, right, based on the analysis, because I know you went to Harvard and studied economics, that in fact, over time, a majority of middle-class people will be paying more in taxes rather than less.
No,
and so we
I don't accept that math.
Well, but
because
that's
it's static analysis,
yeah.
And I don't accept static analysis. I only agree with dynamic analysis, because when you cut, the economy is going to grow. And I know you don't believe that.
I know.
Melissa,
instead of us fighting, let's let David finish. David, go ahead.
Yeah, sure.
Democrats could start by actually being for things they've been for in the past. Ron Wyden and Senator Crapo have actually put a framework not a lot different than what the current Republican bill in the Senate is talking about. So Democrats could actually be for things they've been for in the past, and they could then get on the board for tax cuts. But right now, this is in to honor Roy Halladay. Republicans have the ball in their hand. We got to start throwing strikes. If we start throwing strikes, one, the economy is going to continue to improve for Americans, and two, we're going to be rewarded on Election Day in 2018.
All right, gentlemen, let's leave it there. You know, Simon, you and I are going to have to get a drink sometime. We can't show up and fight like this all the time.
Melissa, don't worry. I'm never coming back on the show ever again, so it doesn't matter. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Hey, Fox News Alert, we're just learning that a federal judge has